I said good day, sir!
Welcome back, everybody, here to your coverage of the defense, season number 3. You know what? For a group stage, which has been including so many different and diverse teams from so many different countries, and some teams we haven't even really heard of or even looked at, I'm really happy to say the group stage has been giving us something very, very unique. Everywhere we look, sometimes it'll be long dodo, sometimes it'll be short dodo, but no matter what happens, everyone is definitely giving it their all. And that's what the defense group stage is all about, showing yourself to the world, having yourself commentate on the international stage, and having the community judge every single thing you do. Let's do the defense season 3, last game of our night. We have 3 games here today, of course 5 tomorrow, then 3 up on Friday. But right now we have Baguette, the French boys, going up against Root Gaming. Without any further ado, let's jump ourselves over now into the main thing which sets our scene for everything. It's called the draft. It's called the draft. As far as our group stage goes, Root Gaming having a little bit of a struggle here so far during the defense. Sitting at 1-for-3 in their group stages. As far as Baguette goes, they haven't really played a lot of their games, only playing 2 of them, sitting at 1-1. Group D, of course, it is the group that requires to actually play the most amount of games, I believe, left here in the tournament. It's just a little bit more... Actually, no. No, they've played through a lot of their games. Almost every single team has managed to play at least 3 to 4 games. It's just Baguette, who was sitting on 1-1, possibly the lowest out of all the teams. Next to Na'Vi, who have only played 3 of their games, and next Impetus, who have also played 3 of their games. They played a couple of their games the other night. So, yeah, Brazil, they've actually got, would you believe, 2 teams doing very, very nicely. Paint Gaming, 2-3. Next Impetus, 1-2. But we're looking at French. Oui, oui, Baguette. Going up against Root Gaming. And Root Gaming, they are the Americans. They'll be playing up. And looking to, well, do what they can, but right now they're also playing with 3 stand-ins, you'll notice. So Stomper, Unicorn, and Dilated Mind will be the 3 players standing in for Root Gaming. Monkeys and Korea, the normal players for Root Gaming. And I think Root Gaming is also looking at their different roster if they're looking to change it around. I believe they've had a couple of issues of late. But these kind of things happen when you go over a large portion of time when it comes to group stages. But Baguette, they've been out the Undying as well as the Batrider, and A as well as the Magnetor being taken out. No Magnetor this time around, because the Desolate Heroes like Darkseer through again. This time it will come in the hands of Baguette, and Shadow Demon and Lone Druid being the first 2 selections here from Stomper. So they overlook the Rubick in favor of the Shadow Demon, which to me is a little bit more of a surprise. Lone Druid's kind of fair enough. Like, Lone Druid's still strong no matter how you look at the board of heroes. You'll never really want to say, hey, Lone Druid, he sucks. Don't pick him. He's fine. Just don't get yourself an anti-mage or a void. Unless you want a game like last game. At which point, get yourself an anti-mage and a void. That's fine. Cottle. Will they couple up with Rubick as well? Will they go for the double whammy of the most popular support heroes in the game of Dota 2 right now? Or are we going to go with a bit more of a core? Look towards our middle lane. Can always pick up the TA and then ban out like Queen of Pain and anyone else that would go up against her in the middle lane. And go a little bit more rotation and movement and aggression to come out. Or do we look at it a little bit more of a passive style lane or a spammy style lane? Coddle and PL. Go back to that old kegger. And that will be something that will help push out against Lone Druid. Nice way to bring down his bear as well. Not to risk yourself. And the bear won't be able to decide who to entangle. That's the downside about Root Gaming's pickups right now. Now they do go with the double couple. They go with Rubick. But it's the downside about Root Gaming's lineup right now. They've got very single-focused heroes. Where Baguette have options of teamfight. Like Feybot will jump through multiples. You've got Cottle with his blast. Always great. Darkseer, who has obviously the best counter-initiation teamfight available. And if he gets strong enough, he can be the initiator. You would say in points where Darkseer will buy up Blink Daggers just so they can initiate and chase. Be that man that's smack bang in the middle of the engagement, popping off that Shiva's Guard, getting that wall up into the perfect vacuum before the enemy are ready for it. And maybe now Stomper will think about going Chaos Knight. Okay. CK selection. Combining it with Shadow Demon Either we're looking at a very aggressive triangle lane, or we're looking at dual lanes. And that'll mean, like, I'm saying aggressive triangle lane being Chaos Knight and Shadow Demon, but going up against a Caudle and Rubick, that's crazy, man. That's absolutely crazy. So I'd assume Root Gaming are going to go for a little bit, something like different, and that's going to be Lone Druid on the top lane for a long lane, and then dual lanes with heroes like CK, Wisp, like Lashrak, coupling up together, like Lina, who, again, like Lashrak and Lina getting overlooked. But that would be the heroes I'm assuming for Stomper. And they'll let them also run like dual lanes. Like, what if we pick up a Kunkka coming the way of Root Gaming, combining up with a CK? So we see SD and Kunkka in mid, CK plus one on the bottom. Dire team back. And they're looking for anybody that's capable of sending up against CK. So Void should also be banned. Maybe worth it taking out the Anti-Mage on top of this. They might not think that though, with Shadow Demon being available. This disruption didn't take any major strength and turn it against him. Burn off all of his mana. Or they could be looking at like Shadow Demon supporting. No, Shadow Demon versus PL wouldn't be worth it. SD is still that setup kind of guy. Yeah, there's a Lashrak ban out. So Beget's thinking the same thing I am. They're looking at what's going to couple with the Shadow Demon. What's going to work well with the CK. Both stuns are setups. Be it through positioning or be it through like set up for long animation time casting stuns. Lone Druid's Entangle also works very much the same way. The CK has a new element which is also reposition through the Reality Rift. But Stomper had to know this. Like when they picked up the CK, it's not a hero which Beget probably would have banned out against them unless they picked up the very obvious support. But right now, we are still looking at Root Gaming. They're missing them. Well, Root? Really? Split push? Well, I suppose if you're looking at everything single focus target, Broomer will be a pain in the butt for you. But then again, then you just get sentries and you attack her and you take the tri lane to her. And Beget would probably look more at a Bounty Hunter or a Windrunner in the off lane. Because even though Windrunner, like, she can get completely nailed out by the Chaos Knight, still having that evasion makes it difficult for Chaos Knight to capitalize enough when he Reality Rifts to start with. And she runs fast enough and has four stuff up and running, she can get a little bit of space between herself when that Chaos bot first wants to fly. Radiant team ban. And Tide is the final ban out. Are they thinking that they're going to run Bounty Hunter? I think so. If they're banning out the Tide... No, if they're banning out the Tunnel, they'll want him himself. I think a Darkseer. Screw my logic. Screw my logic. Saying right now. Just screw it out the window. This will be the final ban out now from Root Gaming. And who do they want to remove? They're banning out Negs. They're banning out Brood. Remaining. Who's going to couple up with Rubick and Caudle? 5 seconds remaining. We've still got Anti-Mage as an option. We've still got Void as an option. Two big heroes to go up against Root Gaming. And then no one's banning out anything against the mid. They ban out PL. Okay. Dire team pick. They ban out the big man who just copies himself all the time. And now Beget, the final one. Is it going to be mid-solo, or do we look for the man that's going to join Rubick and Caudle together on an aggressive try lane, I do hope. The options are there for them. Maybe that PL threw a bit of a spanner in their works. They probably want it, but they've used already so much of their reserve time. Navoja has to make the decision, and they go Sven. So Rubick's Ben and Caudle will be holding hands no matter where they go. It's good stunts, good holds, good damage. Lina. And Lina will be the coupling one now for Stomper to select. Which means one last hero coming the way of Root Gaming as well as Beget. And that's the mid-solo we're looking for now. Unless Root Gaming and both Beget have already decided before the game they'll run two melees, and we see Darkseer up against Lone Druid in the solo mid. It's the only other options. But Templar Assassin is still available inside the pool. And then a couple up nicely with Beget, who are already looking to chase and get really aggressive on the lanes. Nice way to rotate. Either that or they look at Queen of Pain. Templar Assassin. No, we did see the TA, and which should mean Queen of Pain is a logical choice to come back with then. Because they need someone that goes up against TA. Batrider's taken out. Quap is the best selection next to the Invoker. And that could be the other selection too. But that means, like, because you need a Quas, Wex, Invoker going up against a Temple or Assassin. Where with Root Gaming's lineup, they'll make a lot more out of it if they had Nex or Invoker. And that's not something you want to have up against a TA when she starts doing too much damage very early on.
5 seconds remaining.
But Queen of Pain can really stick it to the TA.
Reserve time.
So it'll be the logical choice for them to have. But really, is it going to be their mid-solo? Is that what they're looking at? Or do we look at like CK and Lina going mid-solo? Lone Druid top, Shadow Demon plus one on the bottom lane. That's our other option. CK and Lina can go anywhere they want to. That's why I was talking like with Kunkka with the Shadow Demon before. That way you get the disruption into Torrent. No one on Baguette on the offlane will be able to get away from that. That's if they want to do that. Like, Lone Druid going up against Dark CS seems to be very, very... It's as if Baguette... it's true. Like, if Baguette's going to run the aggressive tri lane, you need something up against that more than a Lone Druid. Lone Druid will die. He will die, most certainly, if he's going up against that aggressive tri lane. There'll be nowhere for him to live. I'm really thinking that's the problem of Root Gaming. They wanted dual lanes, and now... they had to be forced. They had to know they'll be forced into now picking up a solo mid. And they're up against an aggressive try and lane.
10 seconds.
But 9 seconds time, we'll find out. An Invoker. It will be the Invoker selection. Coming the way of the mid. The Korea will take up the Invoker. I'm going to watch very, very close to see how many points up he puts in Exort. To see if it's going to couple with this lane on the bottom. Because it might just give them that extra burst damage to turn around the tri lane. And then heroes like Lina and Shadow Demon can rotate middle lane and help with a balance up against Shadow Demon. Because Shadow Demon will just disrupt the Templar Assassin and then both Illusions attack and then all of a sudden Refraction Charge is gone. And then you're like, oh crap, that wasn't the plan. And life goes hard. But we'll have to wait and see. Rogue Gaming just got selected their last hero. And then we're good to go. Just a reminder too, you can follow all the action of the defense over on the-defense.com. All the overview and pages, the information is there. Or you can just keep up to date with it all from joindota.com, where we have everything available inside the match ticker, as well as all news concerning Dota 2. Everything will be available over there. Let's get ourselves inside the game, peoples. So a quick pause coming out here from Root Gaming. Not feeling 100% ready for this. We can run through already. So we'll have Monkeys going up as the Lone Druid. Puts Korea onto the Invoker. Stomper, Shadow Demon. Dilated Mind. I think I said Diluted Mind before. It was Dilated Mind as the Lina. And that leads Unicorn as our final Chaos Knight. And then over towards Baguette. The French, Vorja. Up as Rubik. Hugo as the Cottle. And I put Slave onto Sven. Masu as the Darkseer. And that leaves Pastor as the Templar Assassin as the final one. I try and put a French action on there like Baguette, which isn't really how you say Baguette. So I'm getting close. It's just a Baguette. But that's the French boys. It's the good humor. It's good humor. There's a couple of these guys which you might even know. It's like Hugo's name. Frog TV cast him a lot. It's the reason why Frog TV are currently inside this game streaming now too. So we've got two English live streams available. I think we also have the boys from Kazakhstan. I think two. Was it the chair? Yeah. And then the French. So a lot of options inside of Dota TV for you tonight. But if you have chosen this audio channel and you're tuning in to me on Dota TV, greetings! And I thank you for your selection of the Join Dota live stream by Toby One. Sup! All right. So, good to go again. So, Hugo's good to go. All right. Hugo? Yeah, Baguette. There you go. Baguette. Not just Hugo. Baguette is more than Hugo. Baguette is all of France. Oh, look at him in little Korea. Cute live over here. Defense. Korea. Guys know where to buy their couriers. These guys, not so much. Donkey meets bear. Bear not sure about donkey. So here we go. What do we got? So, yep. It is going to be the defensive tri lane coming out here from Root Gaming. They're expecting the offensive tri lane, and I don't know why Baguette are not running the offensive tri lane. You've got consumables galore. Are they expecting an aggressive try lane from Roop? Because they're never going to do that. Not up against the Coddle. They need their own positioning. They need their own positioning, or else Hugo is just going to destroy them with Illuminate after Illuminate. And the danger that will come in from the tree line. Yeah, now it was like, oh, wait, guys, whoa, 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 whoa. There's a bear up on top. Bears are not meant to be on top. Bears are meant to be underneath. Shut up. Just shut up. Seriously, just shut up. Time for a drink. All right, so we're going to move from US East and going to remake to Luxembourg. Seems that's a better ping for everybody concerned. I know the French actually have a really bad routing issue going over to America. So if a guy's not a TV, man, you just lost your game. All right, so we'll have a remake. We'll have a remake, and we'll see if our admins are still awake and make sure they're good to go. And then we'll get ourselves back into it. Because as you can see, the overall settings, I said check it out over at the-defense.com. But no, just for you guys, I can display it over here. And you can see how many more games we have left to go. Not that much, really, when it comes to it. Every team plays seven games. Every team plays seven games. Eight teams per group, seven games. You play against each team once. And that's what the cool thing about it all. Everyone gets some good practice. And you look through Group C, like, no talent. They got, like, what, one game left? Two games for EG. Not that much left for Fnatic as well. As we're just connecting back into the game. Should be a nice fast reconnect as well. But the biggest problem I think a lot of people are going to be seeing is just a couple of favorite teams that are not where they really should be. Like 3D Max has completely thrown a spanner in the works. The Danish boys have thrown a complete spanner in the works for Group D. And it really runs the risk. Like Root Gaming, they're sitting a long way down at 1-3. Quad at 0-5, absolute legends, not looking in a great position either, but they're right next to Na'Vi, both are 1-2 in Group D. And the top, Fnatic EU, they look stable as hell up on top of Group D, but 3D Max, 4-1, it can push anybody down. Everything you look at is how many losses you have. If you've got two losses, it's a maybe second position. Possibly. And basically third and fourth is what you fight for. But it's that mainly second position you'll have. You won't be able to contest for number one if you've got two losses. Like, Fnatic will have to lose both their remaining games in order for, like, Na'Vi or AL to have a chance at number one. And then you look over through Group C, and everything's pretty well open. Like, no Tide and EG, they've both got one loss apiece. And then you've got Total Masters and Fnatic NA sitting there with two losses apiece as well. But you got to look at DD Dota. Like, they might have three losses, but if Fnatic and AO Total Masters drop one more game in this group stage, DD Dota really have a chance of coming up. It's the same with Gamers University, but DD Dota are this really up-and-coming team. They struggled in the early stages because they were really trying to get their team back together again, but they've really managed to find a little bit more of their mojo and put it together, and are definitely one of those harder teams to beat here in that Group C. And if you want to check out the rest of them, well, I would allow you to have the free time. I would allow you. You have to allow yourself to have free time to check out the-defense.com, because right now we're back inside the game. So all pick mode is what we get to see. So I don't know if my welcoming message to everybody over there in the world of Dota TV was lost, but I want to say it again. Greetings to everybody over there in the world of Dota TV. It's great to have your selection of this audio channel. We're doing all pick mode for those who have just tuned in. We did the captain's mode before, and then we realized that we're on the wrong server. There's a better server to play in Luxembourg to connect America as well as the French together. And it was, would you believe, Root Gaming that actually asked for it to be changed from US East. Root Gaming being the US team. But I believe they are using a couple of European stand-ins for this one. But we're having some good fun with this one. Plus 200 ping. Life is hard. Life is hard. For the guy in the chat that's spamming out Ocelot's live stream while I will support Own3D TV, seriously, man, you're calling for a whooping, man. You're calling for a whooping. Or just a permanent IP ban. That works too. So let's roll ourselves out. And baguette. will move themselves up towards that top lane. And this time, see, now, this is what I am not sure about from Root. At least we're seeing the aggressive tri lane go to the aggressive tri lane. And that's where it really should have ended up before, instead of sending the lone druid the wrong way. The bear's coming up here and should be the scout out for it all. But the bear saw the aggressive tri lane of Baguette. And now they've switched themselves around so they're up against that. Because again, lone druid, you'll die on that off lane if it's an aggressive tri lane. But if it's Esty and Lina combining it with the Seat Gate, I still don't know how successful that's going to be, depending on what Hugo's capable of doing. And we see this hide around the side. Again, the bear being shown. But it's commitment this time coming out from Root Gaming with their tri lane. And, well, hello, Patso. He's, yeah, you are visible there, man. They know TA is up here as well. And TA will head in towards that mid lane. And Darkseer, he's going to abandon the bottom lane for now. Wesley, as you saw, ringing level 3. But it'll be farming up in this region here and this region here. And just exclusively these two areas. Couldn't help it. hello, bear. Hugo saying hello to Wit. Begins. But it's monkeys. He'll be down the bottom lane, career in towards our middle lane. And then, well, hello, Volja. Looking for Stomper. Stomper thought about going for that disruption, but then Invis ruined by Rubick too strong. And they throw down the sentry wards, get rid of the vision towards the mid. And that gives Korea, and he is going to go with the Xtor build. I was talking about it before, like, up against a TA, you normally go for, like, Quoth versus Wex, get that mana nicely burned out, and have a little bit more life for when she starts getting those Sideblade hits out. But instead, it looks like Korea, in fact, first level, not even going Refraction, straight into the Sideblades. Wants to be aggressive up against Korea. See him just pushing him back. And this is why you go Quoth. The second he saw Exhort, didn't even want Refraction. Refraction can come later. Korea's just looking for last hits right now. And then you look towards the bottom lane where Lone Druid getting his farm. And Darkseer, he's already rotating out of his own jungle. Sees the Lone Druids on bottom lane, not the tri lane. So moves himself down towards the bottom lane and gives more space for Baguette to pull. But we've got an Observer Ward watching when Volja is going to do this. There's that, yeah, the distance of the vision. But this is what I was worried about. Hugo, couple of quarter blasts, keeps the supports to try and hang it just around this region here. Nice and alive. Well, nice and low, I should say, not alive. The opposite of alive. But when this kind of thing happens, then we see the combination come out. CK's already got 2 points up, and whoever he wants to initiate on is dead. That's just what's going to happen here. But Hugo, another quarter blast. He's low. Reality Rift to start off with. Now 2 seconds on that Chaos Ball. Gets the maximum time. Disruption. Just holding the support out. And the Sunstrike's coming in. It's on Volja. They can't choose a target. Stormball hits on 2. And Stomper really low on life. They can't pick up Volja. And now Kotal comes back in again. Gets the first blood. It goes to Hugo. Even though Rubick was instantly killed afterwards. And that was indecision coming out from Root Gaming. They couldn't decide who they wanted. And that's the problem of Disruptor. Of Disruption coming out from Shadow Demon. It's not meant to be that way. It's meant to be a setup kind of ability for somebody else, but this time around, CK was the setup, and that meant when the Disruption happened, sure you hold that extra support out of position, and Rubick wouldn't telekinesis for a moment, but it still caused the issue that it kind of looked like they're focusing on two different targets. But if they did that onto Kotal, then there'll be more time to come in. Disruption, that's going to just hurt Sven a little bit. It's a setup for other people when you disrupt your own targets. But you could already see that Invoker. He's trying to be part of that aggressive tri lane. And for the guy in the chat that's saying that I think the Quoth Wex counters TA, it's not countering, man. It's surviving. Like, you can go the Quoth Exhort, which it looks like Invoker is forced to do. But you need these points up in Quoth, so you're able to survive that extra damage. So when the gank comes, you'll have Cold Snap up your sleeve and just more than a Sunstrike. Until that point, like, TA is 14 for 7 and Invoker, well, 12 for 4, not looking too shabby. Is he going to go top lane again? Hugo. Cold Blast. It's, again, this harassment damage. 2 points up in Chakra. Means he can keep on spamming these out till his heart's content. And Darkseer keeps on intercepting this creep wave. He's not having the easiest time in the world doing it. He's out of consumables now. But it's still free farm for him. But Lone Druid's Bear allows Monkeys to keep this creep wave out as far as he wants to. My Unicorn farms up on the top. Another Cuddle Blast coming. And again, hitting one of the supports this time, not both. It's going to be Lina who has to pop off the salve, and that's her last consumable. There is no more. Maybe a smoke move time, but Dive already got a sentry ward, so even if they smoke up around here, they'll instantly know. And the pull by Vorja. Did a nice job pulling it down, but then Unicorn pulls up the side. Disruption, they're really going to time this with the crit wave on the back of them? I don't think so. Vorja wants to, and then the Cuddle Blast, nice positioning for it too. Warcry to pop off by Sven, but no one's in the neighborhood to really dive with them. As Marsu prepares himself for the middle lane. 2 points up in Surge, you can chase down Korea. TA wants to get in close, but no level 6 just yet. There's no TA traps, being very over-aggressive. Trying to follow that creep wave in between the Tier 1, Tier 2. And that was a direct indication of what they wanted to do. It really needs that level 6. Then the TA traps can help bring down the Invoker. But Invoker's feeling something's wrong, like Darkseer's missing. He could be in jungle, he could be somewhere else. Now Riyadh is going to start up. Vorsha, only 1 second stun. Sunstrike still going to hit pretty nicely. Nukes him down in combination with Lina. Destruction by the Shadow Demon will keep him alive for a moment. The Ursa's in through the side. Tried to get himself denied, which he does do so. Denied to a neutral. The Ursa clamp killed him off. And now Lifestrike Array, as well as the Slave, completely out of position. And support returns by the Rubick. So Lina, able to help with the instant nukage, but can't follow through with a secondary kill. Now Invoker trying to force him out again. But with the Iron Shield damage up on TA, Meld hit as well. Then Quas does its job.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
And now be Chaos Knight up on the top lane. He's got a hold off the side, but he kind of wants to go on that Coddle. Avoids the damage to start with. Already scouted out for... Did Stomper get hit by that, or is he just low anyway? Could have been just low anyway. 6 minute rune doesn't spawn. Up on top. Down on bot. That's an Invis rune. It looks like Korea just wanted to snipe it out, so this Temple Assassin couldn't pick it up. But when you hit level 6 for TA, the TA traps give you vision up and down. This is the biggest weakness of running an Invoker in the solo mid. Your rune control is zero. But she can't move up and down. Like, TA's got vision, she runs phase boots, she can move really in and out really, really fast. And what's just going off and, whoop, Baguette just has to pause the game for a moment. TeamSpeak issue. For some reason, Bucky Mad just came on going, oi, 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 oi! And everyone just has to stop. It's like, yo, dude, TeamSpeak issue. TeamSpeak issue. But it is an issue nonetheless. The Monkey's already being set up for a gank. Marsu's coming down. Can give that surge on the back of TA so she can chase everything down. But then again, probably doesn't even need to. Coming with his just Iron Shell up TA. And with her traps and phase boots, will be easily able to keep up with Monkeys. And Monkeys, he's not until his ultimate form just yet. So it'll depend on how fast they can do this damage to her to get the kill off. And there we go. 3, 2, 1, go. A Monkey, does he feel the pressure on bottom lane? Yep, there we go. Iron Shell, TA trap, gonna trigger. Oh, Monkeys can lose his bear right now too if he's not too careful. And Invis Rune is letting them set up. Iron Shell damage, TA trap, gets inside the ultimate form, and the meld hit. That was a decent amount of damage. Just keep following up, keep throwing it down, and Surge allows him to do so. And that is Lone Druid getting ganked off the bottom lane. Marsu! What are you doing, son? Dives and takes damage from a tower, which is completely unnecessary, but still wants to do it nonetheless, so I'm guessing must be necessary somehow. Well, Invoker's able to free farm even more. Yeah, Marsu's low. It's like Invoker, man, get this. Wait, he used South. Not going to be possible. Unicorn now in a little bit more trouble up on the top. And TP's returning towards the bottom lane. Marsu, he is being chased on down. Monkey's the first one in. Marsu would get on the run. Korea holds his Sunstrike out. 225 damage is not anywhere near enough to kill off that Darkseer, even when he was lower before. Dire's middle tower is under attack. And Slave to go through the creep wave. It's a nice lot of experience coming up from the top. The CK will get his level 5, so we get a 3-2 combo from him. So See an extra pulling up in a Chaos Ball, I assume. I wouldn't be just proven right. That's the only reason why. Okay, he stops farming. Yep, there's Chaos Ball, level 3. And now sees Vorsha. But once Sven, ooh. Try the Reality Rift, but couldn't pull him back in time. Lost the vision around the tree line. And now extra TP comes up towards the top lane. So Masu, Iron Shell, and Surge. Nice rotation. Pick up already. Rubick. Oh, nice double stun. Iron Shell damage still going there. And the Coddle Blast over everybody. Even TA is coming in towards the fight. Three heroes dropping like sacks of potatoes downstairs. 6-2. All five of Baguette rotate up for it. Which, of course, just leaves Korea still farming up in middle lane. Is he going ahead of Vitus Invoker? Is under attack. I think so. And then Monkey's pushing at the bottom tier 1 tower. Fortification will slow this down, but it's not going to stop it. Coddle Blast, Nyan Shell, an entire Dire Creep Wave will hit on top of this tower. Not to mention the Slave's going to ensure the last hit too, and he's stopping himself so he can get it. Yep, there we go. And that'll help him on his way to his drums. More team fight for him, and into the middle lane. TA slows on the trap. Starts with the right, clicks, meld hit as well, drops down a half life, secondary TA trap. To get a little bit more damage up his sleeve. One more right click, and he's got it, and he's got it. And this is the problem. You're running 2 points up in Quas. Didn't get a call snap, didn't pop a single ability. That was just a pure runaway from the Invoker. And it's an Invoker who's trying to go pure damage up against a Templar Assassin who's already had a nice start and just comes off the back of being involved in a triple kill on the top lane. It's not something you want to be dealing with as an Invoker. And TA got the farm early on, like 40 for 16 up against the Invoker, 42 for 8. And TA has been rotating and looking for kills, like being involved in bottom, being involved in top. And Invoker's just sat in that middle lane the entire time trying to farm. And doesn't show on the levels, doesn't show on anything else. We'll see our net worth. Invoker sitting below the three cores of Baguette. And what's our overall? 2,000 going the way of the French. As well as 3,000 experience. Everything just looks nice for them. And we're looking at support items too. What's Coddle on the way to? 800 gold. Should have put up a headdress by now, or at least a buckler. Oh, Darkseer. Well, maybe he's the one doing it, but judging by the start of his build, he could also be doing both things, just to be a casual cloak. And then go into the bigger item later on. Just pick up the mech for now, then go into the pipe. Which we'll see most Darkseers when they go inside the jungle do. Let's look for the more farm that way. Now on bottom lane. Sven's done. Holds both not only monkeys, but also his bear there. Coddle Blast does his job, and then big meld hit comes in from Patso. How many kills is it for him now? 3 kills, 1 assist. And Coddle can pull him. Oh, no, he can't. He's not level 6 yet. He's just short of it. Also doesn't have the mana to really support it, but there goes tier 1 tower in bottom lane. Sven will take that. And then TP in towards middle lane to look down Korea. And TA affords a blink dagger. So initiation, 11 minutes in by TA, just got a whole bunch more stronger. And Rook couldn't deal with it anyway. And look at the Iron Shell Stomper! One Fade Bolt, it's all he needs. Vision around it, and he gets it. And then a stun, 1 second only. And the Coddle Blast coming in too. A little extra damage there on the Unicorn. For the Iron Shell. It wasn't mean to be in that close, Shadow Demon. And he gets picked off. Stomper out of position, and now with basically nothing but consumables Radiant's and branches. And Paso looking to initiate in on Korea before he can just jump himself around. But Lina also coming towards the middle lane. And now jump in. Who's he want to go? Straight on the Invoker. Call Snap going to cause some issue, but there's no follow-up damage. And very unusual Light Strike array. Radiant's middle tower. So we'll just finish up the middle lane. Even if they try and stop him, we've got Sven's Stormbolt directly behind, as well as Drum Charge. So Sentry's down, they're looking for the vision up on the high ground, but it's just not there. But the support's coming in, they don't need the vision to see that. Five-man Dota. Slave will fly through and hit Slave. That's right, that just happened. And then TA Trap, searching out, slows down the Lina. They want the tower, but they also want the kills. Walk right, 2 seconds stun, and the Light Strike array. Holds him out for a moment, but Panso wasn't involved. Just blinked himself in, got the kill. Now another TA trap. 2 heroes called out by that one. Meld hit with the Iron Shell damage. Another right click. Double kill for Panso. And again, this five-man Dota push. Taking towers, taking lives. And then being powered by a defense courier. Because they're boss. And Monkey's Force back in the bottom lane. What's he looking at his items? Like Hand of Myers, Tranquil Boot, 1600. He's got to work his way into going that Mjolnir, or at least getting Maelstrom this early on. And they need that extra strength, and now they're searching for him. They know he's got a TP scroll, but Rubick, walk in, just do it. Just do it. Monkey should have TP'd out by now, but he hasn't. So Partso will come in. He's got a regeneration rune, and now spots the bear. It's like, hey, that bear attacked me. He's here. Monkey's TPing out. Can't stop it. But he will keep on the bear. Can't get the return, but he also can't kill the bear off. Not unless he's gonna commit way too much time when he really could be farming. Now the push in the middle lane, and then Coddle Blast. See Korea there, just try and switch as fast as possible into the Quas build. We've got 3 points up in that now. Forge Spirits won't be too far off. And that can cause some issues for Patso. If they've got time to right-click it like that, blink up, and then instant death. Just, you could feel it. You could feel Lina's life coming to an end. Disruption doesn't hold Patso well, and then TA trap, and a meld hits here again, and meld hit, and boom, boom, oh, I click! Couldn't finish the job. Could not finish the job. A little bit of extra life points there for Shadow Demon in comparison to Lina. Well, 606 with 3 armor up against 625 with 2 armor. But Mel does more. Korea able to get a pickup solo kill. And then TA. Following through. Mel hit. And there's the double Forge Spirits. Now get rid of the refraction defense charges, but it's the aggression charges, which is the bigger problem just then. And then Sven's done, and then they farm up the rest of the Forge Spirits.
Had you but eyes to see it.
So Invoker for Rubick. And again, another kill coming the way of TA. Might even just see a very early Desolator. That could be the option we look at. Monkeys goes back into farming, but Marsu coming down too. TP down by Vorja. Hugo, he has bought up now the headdress and the buckler. Hasn't got both on himself just yet, but hey, he's waiting for a rainy day. And now an invis rune comes out by the TA. And instantly the pings come down towards the bottom lane. Move back. As fast as you can. TA might even dive this. Force out the tower, dive it out, holds the creep wave out for the moment. That one observer ward that just timed out there from the Radiant side saw it. Saw the invis rune inside the bottle pop. And now it's Root Gaming looking for the best trade they can. And that's mid-tier one. And at the same time, Sven is just free farming up top lane and pushing it out. So it's going to be tier 2 tower. Marsu will hold the creep wave out. And it's going to be Coddle Blast. Fortification can pop. Yep, it will. And then the creep wave's gone, double TP's in, and look at the damage on Lina. Marsu wants to chase it down, surge him up, war cries right there, Storm Bolt will hit, and that's the death of Lina. Sven comes through and just cleaves it up. Vorja was pushing out the middle lane. Where's our Templar Assassin run off to? She's in middle lane too. Well, they might look for the tier 2 tower in mid. So the push comes out from Root, that mid tower, not deniable, it's just above it. And the TP out by Lone Druid, he gets back out to safety. But the middle lane's going to be pushed out pretty harshly. And Coddle Blast again. Stomper moves back out of range. Only just. But he does. And we're going actually in for Roshan. Hey, why not? Pastor will be the first one to tank it up. And then Slave also in. Hiding off his God Strength for now. Doesn't feel it necessary. Which is true. Small enough damage coming out from the rest of this team. It's interesting to see if they'll give the Aegis the Immortal over to TA or over to Sven. TA is the more aggressive, so she'll be the more logical, but... no, she'll take it. Sven can just be that support, strengthy kind of guy. And what do we got flying in? Was something bored up? Headdress and full pipe. So the mech comes up from Coddle, and the pipe comes up from Darkseer. And the mech is not done on Coddle. In fact, the courier could have waited a little bit longer before he delivered this. So then they'll have both mech and pipe. And this push that could be happening right now wouldn't just be a stop push. It would be a continuous push into the tier 3 tower. Even 17 minutes in, the strength of Baguette is strong enough that they can force tier 3 towers. They just can't rotate to win anything else. It looks like Hugo will be the man to defend up the middle lane. Keep that pressure off the tower. They could see it coming too, even inside the smoke, because the sentry ward was still there in the mid. But the tier 2 tower goes down on bot, and then quick TP's up towards top. They're looking for CK. And Marsu will try and defend it. But the support, Invoker with a haste rune. He wants to go. He can't cut his way through this tree line. He'll have to dive it in. And that means taking up the tower, which I don't think he's a massive fan on, especially if Baguette's going to TP in support. And the Iron Shell damage, well, Darkseid hits level 11. Got some really nice levels too. 3 points up in Surge, which is more interesting. It's not the normal build. Normally you see 4-4-2 and then the rest of the ulti before you start leveling up your Surge. But he's done it because Baguette's just been so aggressive. That's what it's all meant for. Just the full-out aggressiveness. And TA then gets a defensive item. Damn you! Damn you, Pazto! Slayer coming down towards the bottom lane. And they're looking at monkeys. TA trap. Slow him down. Sven's war crying so he can catch up. And even then, Pazto slowing him down with a body block, but gets entangled. Stormbolt. They'll just focus on the bear now. Melted on it. Melted on it. Not gonna do it. They can't chase it down far enough. Invoker's coming to support. So they gotta fall back. At the same time, this is two men causing issues. Hugo's in a little bit of trouble. Light Strike Array and the Sunstrike. Man, that's overkill.
Oh, you're hot.
Well, they get the kill nonetheless, but that means now Laguna Blade on cooldown. Radiant's jump yourself in. Lina's got no mana apart from a TP out. And now, was it Chaos Ball? Yeah, Chaos Ball stolen. Already got one. Search out for Unicorn. He's gonna walk over the top of a TA trap and know exactly where he is. Just so they try and cut him off for the pass. Nope, why bother? Push out the T2 tower in the mid. Map control is what the French want. It's what they're gonna get to. Nothing's really gonna stop them from doing this.
Radiance middle tower.
These forward spirits try and do what they can, but instantly forced back. Career at least able to get rid of a couple of things, like that hand of Midas is just giving him a little bit of extra gold to play around with as far as items go before Starver's basically hit with his face boots. And now Marsu. Could be careful to be entangled, but a pick up at the bear and throw down. Holds even the four spirits back, and then Cuddle Blast. And four spirits are gone. I've still got these negative armor points, which really annoy the crap out of most people. But jam up on Keeper of the Light. There's just no vision then for Root Gaming to have once he starts searching for him. He hasn't cleared up the walls in the middle lane. Just want to push this mid lane instead. Cuddle Blast right through the SD. And then the follow-up's done. Pazto, two right clicks to do the job. Wish does do so, then gets 2 seconds on himself. But nice Darkseer wall. Looking for the extra stun up in Unicorn, but not going to work. I think it was the blinding light that forced him out. And now another Cuddle Blast. Not to be get caught in range of that one. And God's Strength is there by Slave. Fortification gets slowed down. Sunstrike hits on Pazto. But the bear's out too far. That's the bear lost. And that's the guy with the relic. He has to resummon that now. And then cannot risk dying. Slave, Deafening Blast, oh, nice little pullback in again, but Marsu surges himself away. Tier Trap ensures he can do so. And then another Cuddle Blast just to annoy the crap out of him. And they fall back. The French are already doing their damage. Don't need to risk too much. Even if Templar Assassin does, yeah, well, there's your BKB. Sitting back at base. Well, another Mithril Hammer is here for Slave. So is his BKB fully done as well. So we've got double BKBs, or Coddle. Blink down, gonna find a regeneration room for TA. We'll wanna pop this, and now, whoops, stun out from Vorja. And they're gonna force like a stun out in the Chaos Knight, and the Fade Bolt, Laguna Blade, and the Slave, everything they've got, and in comes Pazto. They've already basically blown their load. Sunstrike will come on in, there's minimal damage to nothing. Cuddle Blast will fly through, but they've already split in Pazto. Meld hit, Deafening Blast gonna push him back. He wants a little bit more, but Lion Strike Array will hit again. And he's lost a lot of armor. He wants to finish this. He's got Aegis the Immortal. He'll just go it. Lina will live for the moment. Light Strike Array, too early. Look for the follow-up blink. Does so, and finds it. Lina in the trees! Didn't see him. And now support rotates in from the side. Pazto, this cold. Cold Snap not helping out. Blink, 2 seconds. 1 second, now can go. Follows down, TA Trap on cooldown. Wants a melt hit, Unicorn's here to help out. And the pings come to fall back. Nice little juking out here by Root. Lina is so lucky, but they didn't work through the Aegis. Lina. It's the second time in 1 week I've seen that same juke spot being used. But it's support on no life whatsoever, and it's just never 100% checked. I'm pretty sure in the future, We'll see TA check it out a lot more. Wait, whoa, illusion rune. Illusion rune. It's, yeah, I ping it, not your teammates. And he turns, no, he's gonna let it go. Is anybody else running bottle? I don't think so. No. TA just doesn't like illusions, huh? Either that or she just didn't see it. Checking the top rune? No, just walking up top? Didn't want to... That makes no sense. It makes no sense whatsoever. And looks like we're going to have this Ven pulled in. Oh, hello Disruption, already starting off, and it's this Masu. Masu's in here. CK are way too far. There's your back! Into the perfect wall by Darkseer again. The Entangle holds Ven out for the moment, but he just doesn't care. He's not taking damage from it. They'll take out the tower. Lone Druid on 22 life points. He left that fight in region 27. Well, they'll just force it out. Lone Druid's already lost one bear. He can't resummon if he loses another. And I mean, Radiance is gone. Already pulled the aggro off, but then Coddle Blast through everything, including Forged Spirits. Masu is burning off a little bit. It's annoying him a little bit. Then pick up by Rubik. Oh, they got the bear outside. Quick recall. Tier 3 tower's gone. 4 seconds up on Slave. And then Chaos Bolt stolen by Rubik. Deafening Blast to push him out, but Coddle Blast also makes it difficult when they come in. Laguna Blade, Masu can't go down this one. Stuns out in two heroes, melted it by Partso. Already picks up the Lina for the price of the Darkseer ever. And then we split ourselves up. Monkey's on one side, pick up, throw down. CK looking to chase down Slave, and he can do so. There's no extra charges, the drum's already been used. Got good movement speed, Chaos Bolt, 3 second stun, and then 4 second return by Vorja. But Vorja, entangled, held, and gone. And even Templar Assassin brought down by Korea. So overextension. And they don't bring down the racks. But get at everything. They had all the farm. They had a 15,000 gold advantage and almost an 11,000 worth of experience advantage. Obviously, not enough. That's the problem when you go BKBs up on a team. Like, well, what's the magic? Well, Root do have a lot of control. But when these entangled chances hit and you're happy to take Radiance burn damage, you've got to be cautious of that. Now Hugo wants to bring some help back in. Pops the oldie form. Give a free TP to the Darkseer. He's already sitting back there. Come on, pull him in. Pull him. Pull him, pull him, pull him, pull him, pull him. Not doing it. A double arcanes too. Only one arcane. Hugo's saving his cash for something. Interested to know what. There's our TP's up towards that top lane. Now crits up on Sven. Finally some damage dealing items coming the way of Baguette. Yeah, crit up on Sven as well as TA. They're going mirror builds right now, apart from the Blink Dagger. It's drums for a Blink instead. I think it's about the same cost. Whoops, too many R's. Nah, a little bit more expensive to get a Blink Dagger. Just an extra 500 here or there. We'll see Baguette form up as 4 again. Roshan's up in 1 minute time. And Invoker. trying to be an absolute boss. Showing micro with just himself as well as 2 Forged Spirits. Not the best micro in the world, but still trying to make the dire side. Just think twice about, well, where is he? And now smoke. Ooh. If they had their eyes peeled, they would have seen it. No. Yeah, they realize not real. Not real. Smoke doesn't get revealed. Again, not real. TA trap on mid. There's already the jump in. Man, look at that speed coming in with the surge and drums back in. Is there another Darkseer wall? There's already 2 heroes. Both the supports now lost for Root Gaming. They need that top lane to push in. But BKB plus the God Strength for a very short amount of time. Creep Wave is going to push in through the middle lane. Now give them the opening. Or is that backdoor regen? Not kicking in just yet. Nice Deafening Blast with the Meteorite. Good combination coming out here from Korea. And now onto Slave. The bear's gone. There should be a resummon again. Yeah, there is. The Darkseer wall holding them out. Fortification. Stopping Baguette for a moment. There's still no backdoor regen because the creep wave came in through the mid. Now the top one replaces it. Unicorn, BKB, starts up on Slave. Brings him down. Nice disruption. Actually, no, it's not. It's from his own team. Unicorn couldn't combo correctly now. And now he's forced back. The BKB's worn down. Coddle Blast through him. TA, right clicks. More than enough damage. Finishes the job. Then now can go for the bear. Remember, it's already resummoned up again, but they want monkeys. He will go down as well. No point in buying back for him. The top ranks will be lost. He buys back anyway. And what was stolen? Was it Laguna? It was Laguna. Laguna Blade is stolen. That'll be the death of Korea if it hits. With the help of the Coddle Blast, of course. But that's melee ranks gone, and Baguette are falling back. I don't want to stick around. Rubik TP's all the way back to... Bay, no, it's to bottom tower. But that's also a level 2 ultimate he had. So that's there to stay for a long time. Buys up a little bit more life, and they will look at Roshan. That's probably the main reason why they're back now. And TA with Crystals looking at full Daedalus. Slayer's still on his way to getting that. Vorja does go in. Says, yo guys, Roshan, kill, kill, go, go. Yeah, yeah. And a double damage rune to boot for the Templar Assassin. This should be a very quick Roshan. So in we go. Already starting off with the crits, the negative armor. Negative 5 for Roshan. He's holding the DD rune. Not even requiring it to get this kill. But when the entire team is here, may as well pop off that mech coddle. Give everyone their life back again. Or is it just like, yeah, you'll heal up. Who cares? And there's Slave now. Oh, he's just short. 90 gold short of having it. And that's why the courier is now moving his way out. Oh, we got Shiva's Guard as well. And that's coming out for Marsu and Hugo. In fact, he is going to buy up a sheep stick of all things. Drops a sentry wall, which means also he can send that courier back and pick up his void stone. Which means all of his chakra can go out to his teammates as opposed to a little bit over to himself. And now the bear is back up again for monkeys, but it's another 104 seconds he's got if he loses it. And there's the pickup. Will they try it? They kind of want to. There's five heroes here. They just need the creep wave. Top lane will push itself out. But not with that, not with the momentum behind it. Mega melee creeps on, like, they do enough, but it's not enough. What the hell? All right, creep wave, going through mid. Kill, kill, go, go. Another Coddle Blast. All they want to do is just force Root Gaming to dive, and there's the wall. They're holding them off. Like the Great Wall of China, you do not want to cross it. Slave popping off the God Strength. Is he going to get stunned off? Who do they go on? Try and go on the support. Vorja, he's still got that Laguna Blade. Just pick a target. Pick a target and kill it. There's already too many targets going down. Unicorn on such low life. He's right clicked out. It's a triple kill for Slave. Too much damage. Cleaving out. Bear's gone on bottom lane. Monkeys will follow through. Where's Laguna? Laguna it. Laguna it. He hasn't even used it. It's another kill for Partsel. Korea, now will you Laguna? No, he's actually still Reality Rift. Okay, Lunar Ult, the Lunar Ult is not enough. He doesn't want to use it, it costs too much mana. He wants to pop everything else off instead. And there goes Minrax. And they can rotate bottom very, very quickly. Already with the creep wave pushing in. And GG, well played. Baguette will take the win here in the group stages. Up against Root Gaming. Of course, there's more group stages coming up tomorrow. Brazil going up against Kazakhstan will be the first game of tomorrow. And that'll be Pain going up against NextKZ. XX5, the Russians, going up against Absolute Legends. And then more to come. And then a big change on Friday, not only to our studio setup, hopefully it'll be a little bit more stable for you all. Also a little bit of higher quality. But we'll be looking over to see NextKZ play up against Dignitas. Dignitas also going up against MCW that night, and then Absolute Legends to face up against Na'Vi, who are in the position where they can't even take one more loss. If they do, they're in trouble. In fact, they could find themselves completely out of the defense before the group stages are over. And that'll be, well, heartbreaking for some people, also a bit of a, it'll be more shameful in another way. And just bring down the bear. We've got one attacking the bear. Just turn around, Parcel. Get rid of the bear. Meld Hit will take care of it. But he wants monkeys. I'll just chase him out. The top racks is now going to go too. So it is full mega creeps now in favor of Baguette. And while the GG has been called, Root Gaming still playing around until the very last moment. But that's a nice creep wave coming in through the top. Good momentum on it. And the creep wave through the bottom. On Parcel. Really fantastic rotation from him. 18 for 1 at the end of the day, he gets. And that is just a strong TA solo mid that the Invoker just, well, it didn't work against him at the end of the day. And now Unicorn, he's looking for some collateral. Vorja is going to be his collateral. If he can finish the job, no he can't. He'll die himself. And that is GG, and very, very good evening to you all. Thanks for watching. Thanks for watching. As always, check out the VODs if you missed anything from today over on joindota.com. You can check it out for the O3D TV links there, or youtube.com/joindoty. You'll find the VODs over there. You can also check out a couple of my personal things over on youtube.com/toby1dota. I post up a little bit of a Minecraft video tonight, so if you want to check that out, definitely do so, as well as follow me on Twitter and Facebook. Toby1dota for everything. Like, just, yes, it's easy. It's easy. It's very, very easy. All right, thanks for watching, guys. I'll catch you all tomorrow evening. I believe we started a little bit earlier, and it should be just around, I think we're going about like 5 o'clock. So yeah, look at Join Dota. I'll come and broadcast. I'll give you a countdown. I'll tell you everything you need. Thanks for watching, guys. See you tomorrow.
I said good day, sir!